Hey, have you ever thought about while sitting stationary in the morning traffic that there must be a better way for commuting, but you don't like public transport or it's just non-existent in your part of the world? And you don't want to cycle in the rain? Well, how about trying a Velomobile like this? Hello and welcome to the Velomobile channel. So why would you want to commute by Velomobile instead of a regular upright bike? Well, if you have a long commute, like let's say 20 to 30 kilometers or maybe even more, then you need a very efficient bicycle, and Velomobiles are the most efficient type of bicycles around. With a very efficient Velomobile like this, you can ride your commute much faster than regular upright bike, but still use same amount of energy, or you can travel in same time and use way less energy. For example, I have a commute of 25 kilometers and I can ride it in about 40 to 45 minutes depending on which Velomobile I'm using. And Velomobiles are basically classified as a bicycle, so you can ride on bike paths instead of the road where there's usually a lot of traffic. Then Velomobiles are very comfortable, they have usually very good luggage space for your stuff, and then they have very good weather protection, and then, well, this, I think this is the most important thing, the drivetrain is enclosed inside the Velomobile body, so it doesn't get dirty if you ride in the rain. So this means that you need much less maintenance. So if you want to commute by Velomobile, there's few things you need to have before you can do it. First, you want to make sure there's a good and safe place to park your Velomobile at work. And now I'm assuming you have also a good place to store a Velomobile at home. Otherwise, owning a Velomobile might not be feasible. Then you should have a possibility to take a shower at work. I don't know about you guys, but I do sweat a lot, so I do need to take a shower after commuting. If you have a very short commute, then you probably can make it without breaking a sweat, but then you might not even need a Velomobile for that. But on the other hand, why wouldn't someone want a Velomobile? Okay, so now if you have these two things sorted out, then you can start to think what kind of Velomobile you should have. Because if you want to commute by Velomobile, then you of course need a Velomobile. But if you already have a Velomobile, then you will of course use that one. But if you are considering about buying a new one, then here's few tips about what kind of Velomobile you should get.
Well, first of all, you should get as efficient Velomobile as possible. It makes your life easier if you can save some energy on your morning commute by riding a very efficient vehicle. But then you might have to compromise efficiency to some other features like ground clearance or better turning radius or larger luggage space or just a bigger model so that you can actually fit in.
For example, I bought this Quattro Velo because this has child seat, so I can take my kids to daycare and back again. And then also this one works in the Nordic winter, so I can actually use this Velomobile much more than any other type of Velomobile.
If you are commuting daily, then you might need to ride during dark hours, like on early mornings. So you might want to upgrade to better lights. So if you are buying a new Velomobile, different models have usually several lighting options, so you might want to check those out and upgrade to better lights. Or if you already have a Velomobile, maybe add some extra lights, like extra headlights or extra taillight. Actually, I'd say that extra taillight is more important. It increases your visibility and safety. Then I recommend to buy extra battery for your light system. On my Quattro Velo, I always carry extra battery with me, so when the headlights run out of juice, I can just swap the battery. Makes life easier. This Milan came with only one battery, so I just have to make sure that the battery has enough juice all the time. Then you might want to consider electric assist. Well, not if you live in a place like the Netherlands, which is completely flat and has no real winter. Then it doesn't make sense, but in a mountainous area, it would be great to have e-assist on a commuter vehicle like a Velomobile.
Then few more things which you need if you are commuting daily. You need some kind of tools and spare parts. For example, in my Quattro Velo I carry this huge tool bag with tools and spare parts like spare tubes. Then I have this huge floor pump and this portable mattress which I can use if I have to tip the Velomobile over to replace a tire or something like that. I can carry this much stuff because I have so huge luggage space here in the Quattro Velo. So there's still plenty of room for your stuff, like your extra clothes and lunch and a laptop or whatever you need during the workday. But all this is kind of overkill. You actually don't need this much stuff because, well, usually you don't have to do complete overhaul of the Velomobile on the side of the road. So what you actually need, some spare tubes, maybe some tire repair kit and tire lever just for backup, and a pump. For example, here in this Milan I carry this kind of small pump, so I don't have to carry this kind of huge floor pump. In this Milan all this stuff, this fits nicely here in this little shelf here, behind the seat, so there's more room in the actual luggage space for your stuff. Then in addition, you may need some tools to open some hatches or service covers or something on your Velomobile, if you have that kind of covers.
So this is basically all you usually need to carry in a Velomobile. But now that I mentioned this Milan, which is by the way provided by velomobileworld.com, so it's not mine. So even this one, which has pretty tight interior space, has enough luggage space for commuting. In most cases, you only need some spare clothes, maybe your lunch or other snack, and maybe your laptop. There's plenty of room for that kind of stuff, even though the luggage space is tiny compared to a Quattrovelo and small compared to a Quest.
Then one other thing you need to do is to click the like button, so this video can reach all the people who might be interested about commuting by a Velomobile. Damn, there's strong wind, oh shit!
Then when actually commuting by Velomobile, you should choose your route wisely. Velomobiles have usually pretty small ground clearance and huge turning circle. Some models are worse than others, so you want to avoid any sharp turns and speed bumps and high curbs. But you will quickly learn which is the best route for a Velomobile.
Okay, then there are a few more tips about commuting, but I've already made this video about commuting in general, so go watch this one next. It's excellent video, but I just forgot one advice from that video, and that is to reserve enough time to take a shower after the commute. But okay, I think that's all for today. Thanks for watching, and see you next time. Bye bye.